Dear learners, welcome to NIOS Studio. I am Dr. V.P. Joshit, Assistant Professor, Department of Education, Central University of Kerala. Today, we will discuss about scientific temper and scientific attitude. Isaac Newton once told, "I do not know what I may appear to the world, but to myself, I seem to have been only like a boy, playing on the seashore and diverting myself in now and then, finding a smoother pebble on a prettier shell than ordinary, while the great ocean of truth lay all undiscovered before me." This really seems to be a beautiful quest which comes from Newton, that whatever we see, whatever which is present in front of us, many things, millions of things which are there, which are hiding from our sight. That is what is where curiosity rises. And here we just talk about science. Science is all around us. Either we have to know it, or it is important to have an understanding of science for everyday life. We can regard good science education as one that is true to the child, true to life, and definitely true to science. Science is about asking questions and finding answers to them through scientific method and inquiry. Science is important to all young people for not only the knowledge associated with it, but also to imbibe its inquiry and process skills. Science has got both product as well as process aspect. Again, what is science? Science is the attitude of questioning and reasoning. Here, we just call not a science, it is like scientific temper, which means the attitude of questioning and reasoning. So, scientific temper comes from science. It is an approach of believing only facts supported by relevant evidences, where these evidences are derived from observation, logical interpretation, and conclusion made from experiment or experience which is repeatable under similar condition. Scientific temper means believing things to the extent of evidence availability. Again, how do you believe things? We believe things based on evidence. Only with available evidence, we just go for interpretation or we just go for reasoning. That is what is scientific temper says. Now, scientific temper is a true path. Actually, it is a true pathfinder and guide for our life. It is not only complex scientific methodology, but it's built on solid base of humility, freedom, courage, fearlessness, and humanity. Again, scientific temper is a thought process which believes universe run on its own by natural laws. This means that whatever which is happening in and around us has been governed by some of the laws which seems to be natural, and all these natural laws are said to be scientific. Then, scientific temper means the meaningful questions which are very specific to which we ask in every situation, whether it may be a classroom situation, whether it may be a life situation, whether it may be an interaction with our peers, or it may be an interaction with anyone. When we ask a question and the question has got meaning, it has got some syllogism, it has got some syntax, then we call this a scientific temper. Now, what is the importance of scientific temper? Scientific temper will lead to develop attitude of questioning and reasoning in every situation, Such attitude will boost countries' techno-social development. Again, it is not only for people, even for country. We need to have people with scientific temper, because the people's scientific temper is directly linked to the social or even technical development of the country. Now, scientific temper made human to understand certain things. See, first one, there is reason behind every happening. This reason can be understood by human. Again, what we have told, we have just given an understanding that every happening has got some reason, and all these reasons can be understood by human beings. The efficiency of approach and availability of right resources will decide time, completeness, and correctness of explanation. Then, scientific temper forms, this is the surest way to obtain the correct explanation for unknown happenings. So, that is again which is the result of scientific temper. Now, we have a very good diagram. Here sees, it is a refusal to accept anything without any trial or test, which means scientific temper. Now, it is a reliance on observable facts rather than on preconceived theory, all those theories which we have in our mind. We just rely on the facts than on the theories in our mind. We just depend on the facts and we just work with the facts. Because if we have already a theory in our mind, even the observations are contradictions. Again, we just stand with the observations rather than our conceived notions. Now, it is disciplining the mind. Again, you are just having a character formation. You are just making your mind to behave to some norms where you are getting disciplined. Now, it is a support for finding out the truth. Again, scientific temper means the support for finding out the truth. We just go with a quest, and our quest is that we just want to find some truth behind the happenings. And when we have such behavior, when we do with such notions, we shows the character of scientific temper. Now, it is the capacity to change previous conclusions in the fact of new evidences. Again, we have already told, sometimes we have a theory in our mind and we get lot of observations, lot of understandings that we have, and all these observations that we have sometimes may be contradictory. Even then, we just go with the observations that we got. Here also, we once again reiterate that we just change our previous notions, we just change our previous conclusions to the fact of evidence, the fact of new evidence. Now, it is to discover cause-effect relationship. Again, science is a thing where you have cause-effect relationship. Again, if you are going to discover, if you are trying to discover the cause-effect relationship, again, it shows scientific temper, because we have a cause-effect relationship. Now, it is to accept the things, it is not to accept the things blindly. Again, we have already told, we just go for evidences. We never accept things blindly, because evidences are the foremost thing that we need as a person of science. Now, it is the finding of facts first or search for facts. Again, what do? We just find the fact first. After that, we just search for fact, or instead of finding the fact, we just search for fact. Now, it is a search for truth and for new knowledge. Again, scientific temper has given an understanding that scientific temper gives a search for truth. and scientific temper gives you a new knowledge. So these are the various characteristics, or these are the various things which we call in actual sense that scientific temper possess. Now, see what are the characteristics of scientific temper. First one, healthy skepticism, universalism, freedom from prejudice or bias, objectivity, open-mindedness and humility, willingness to suspend judgment without sufficient evidence, rationality, perseverance, which means the positive approach to failure. Now, we just see what does scientific temper means to an individual. Scientific temper shape our attitude to life. Scientific temper becomes a part of our character. During childhood, while the child is still learning how to respond to the vagaries of everyday life, here comes again the process of scientific temper. It is an effective method of developing scientific temper is the use of discovery approach to teaching. All aspects of our life, personal, social, economic, political, and even religious, are just linked to that. Now, it is a logic and rationality. Now, egalitarian, democratic, secular, and universalist outlook can be developed when you possess scientific temper. Now, attitude, that is what is we are going to discuss. So, we just discuss about scientific attitude. Attitude is a predisposition of mind towards an object or person or phenomena. According to National Society of the Study of Education, NSSE, scientific attitude can be defined as open-mindedness, a desire for accurate knowledge, and the expectation that solution of the problem will come through the use of verified knowledge. Scientific attitude is composed of number of mental habits or of tendencies to react consistently in certain ways to a novel or problematic situation. These habits include accuracy and intellectual honesty, along with the habit of looking for true cause-effect relationship. Now, characteristics of scientific attitude. See, we have discussed about scientific temper, scientific attitude. Both of these concepts has got lot of resemblances. Now, because of that, the characteristics also will have the same sort of resemblances. Now, we just see the characteristics of scientific attitude. It is curiosity or inquisitiveness, objectivity, belief in cause-effect relationship, open-mindedness, perseverance, ability to accept failures, skepticism. Now, we will see people with a scientific temper or scientific attitude. See, those people who has got scientific temper or scientific attitude will show respect to other person who has this scientific point of view. So, see here what we are going to do. Here we are ready to respect others. Even if anyone says something which we find it has got some logic and they are not from science, the simple logic just say that he has got a scientific attitude and we do respect that person's mindset. Now, open-minded towards the work and opinion of others and towards information related to his problem. Again, people with scientific attitude, scientific temper will be always be open-minded to the opinion as well as to the information that he gets related to his problem. Now, those people looks for the nature of causes of event. So, whatever the event which is happening, we just say that how the event takes place and we just look for the causes of event. Now, people with scientific temper or attitude bases opinions and conclusions on adequate evidence, because each and every opinion or each and every conclusion made from the opinion will be based on evidence. Again, evidence has got primacy and we rely on evidence. Now, these people evaluate techniques and procedures used and information obtained. See, whatever the techniques, whatever the procedures we adopt, we just go through once again. And those procedures, those techniques which has been adopted by other people also will be evaluated, and at the same time we evaluate the quality of the information, we evaluate the strength of the information, and this is the characteristics of people with a scientific temper or attitude. Now, these people will be curious concerning the things he observes. So, whatever he observes, whatever which comes in his life, whatever which comes in his vision, he will be curious of its identity. He will be curious of its nature. He will be just observing, not like a layman observes. He will be observing like a person who will be observing each and every traits. Now, scientific temper and scientific attitude, we just go for some comparison. Scientific temper is regarded as the mode of behavior, whereas scientific attitude is a mental state. Again, one is a preoccupation of our mind and another one is a behavioral trait which we possess for each and every action. Both are associated to some extent and differentiated as well. I have already told both this concept, it is very difficult to differentiate. At the same time, they have got some differences, because both these concepts are resembling, or both these concepts have resemblances to a maximum extent, and at the same time they have got their own differences on certain things which really defines both this concept. Now, scientific temper uses scientific methods based on scientific knowledge to solve problems. This is what is scientific temper, uses the scientific methods based on scientific knowledge. Scientific attitude also needs knowledge of science, but it is not mandatory. That is very important. Previously, what we have told? We have just told that those people with a scientific temper uses the knowledge of science. Here also, people with a scientific attitude uses the knowledge of science, but even an illiterate person may have sufficient attitude if he has a progressive outlook. So, an illiterate person can also have scientific attitude when he has a progressive outlook. So, it does not mean that only educated people has got scientific attitude. Now, scientific attitude involves curiosity, observation, testing, anxiety to the changes of surroundings and environment, anti-superstition, measures of good health, vaccination against contagious disease, etc. are the important traits in scientific attitude. See, we have to take some measures to maintain our health. Especially, we have to go for certain vaccinations, because vaccinations are very important in keeping our health for a long time. So, these are all things which comes as a part of scientific attitude that one generate in his life. No one can expect scientific number from those who has no scientific attitude. That is another point of view. If you have scientific attitude, then you can have the scientific temper. Even without scientific attitude, you cannot develop scientific temper. Now, scientific attitude involves curiosity, observation, testing, and anxiety to the changes of surroundings and environment. So, here we have discussed these things like measures of good health, which we have already told, vaccinations, which we have already told, which comes as a part of scientific attitude. So, I hope that we have discussed some real characteristics of scientific temper. How does scientific temper differ from scientific attitude? What do people with scientific temper shows? Or how can you differentiate those people with scientific temper and scientific attitude? And is it necessary that education is very important to develop scientific attitude? Because education is very important. There is no argument for that. But we can have a sense that those people, those illiterate people, if they have a progressive outlook, they can develop scientific attitude. Hope that you enjoyed this session. So, thank you. Have a nice day.